Good afternoon, and welcome back to EDM News. Today's segment, we have three very special guests joining us. Our first two guests are economists from Cameroon and America, respectively. Now, we have them both in call today to talk to us. How about you both introduce yourselves, starting with you, Darian.
Hey, Ethan. Thank you very much for inviting me to talk on EDM News. It is an honor. Anyways, my name is Darian. I graduated in the 90s. With a PhD in economics from the University of Douala. And ever since then, I've been teaching there. And basically, I'm here today to give a little bit of insight on the economic structure in Cameroon.
Hey, Ethan. Thanks for having me. It's an honor to be on the show. My name is Max, and I'm an economic researcher currently working for Stanford University. I have a PhD in economics from the University of Chicago, and I've been working as an economic researcher for the past 15 years, working alongside various universities and state governments.
Alright, thank you for both introducing yourself. Now let's cut straight to the chase. The audience at home wants to know about the difference in economics and your economic system. So how about you go ahead now and each describe your country's economics, starting with you, Max.
Thank you, Ethan. I think many at home may already know this, but the United States of America is an economic powerhouse. Our nation is one of the most influential, strongest, and most valuable countries in the world. I would say we are trendsetters in terms of economics. The United States is an integral part of the supply chain for many industries, and our imports and exports are some of the most vital in the Western world. When America is profiting, the whole world is profiting. Our stock markets have effects on the whole world. When the American stock market dips, the rest of the world dips, and same vice versa. If you want some statistics on the United States, they have the largest GDP in the world at $14.71 trillion as of the end of 2008. That's right, trillion with a T. We are almost triple that of the second largest economy, that being Japan, with a GDP of 5.038 trillion. Our GDP per capita for 2008 was $48,382.56 US. And judging that our nation has a population of over 304 million people, we are one of the most wealthiest countries in the world.
Yeah. So after coming out of a harsh recession in the 1980s, due to drops in export prices, Cameroon has been recovering and getting a little better day by day. We did get very lucky as Cameroon has great agricultural land, and this helped us get back on our feet and work towards a more stable economy. Although unlike Max stated about America earlier, our economy is still a little shaky to this day. Around the year 2000, the Cameroonian government took a more socialist approach and made plans for various rural and urban developments, as well as expansion of educational facilities and much, much more. Although this didn't quite work out as planned, and Cameroon ended up taking more of a capitalist model. This therefore led to less central planning and had more reliance on private enterprises instead.
Wow, that was very informative. Thank you for sharing that. My next question has to do with the recent stock market crash. We all know with the Lehman Brothers' recent collapse, lots of countries' economies have taken a hit. How big of an effect has that taken on your economy? Let's start with you, Darian.
Yeah, of course. So pretty much building off what I was saying earlier, the capitalist model that Cameroon took upon paid a big price with the collapse of the Lehman Brothers company, which led to the 2008 market crash. And like I mentioned earlier, Africa is known for its agriculture and its very valuable raw materials. And at the time, international trade had dropped a whopping 11%. And with these exports being one of Cameroon's main sources of GDP, this drop really hit them hard. This drop recorded 2,000 layoffs occurring, and 20,000 jobs were threatened from this. And this led to increasing rates of unemployment and poverty nationwide, and really left a dent in the Cameroonian economy for years to come.
Well, Ethan, Lehman is one of the largest and most respected investment banks in the United States, and their collapse has been a huge toll not only on our economy, but on the everyday lives of Americans. You know, the crisis that erupted from the bankruptcy of the Lehman Brothers has been the worst financial crisis since that of the Great Depression way back in the 30s. Now, there are some similarities between the two crises. However, the biggest difference, in my opinion, has to be the rate at which the two developed. The Great Depression sparked back in late 1929. However, the major banking crisis in America did not occur until late 32, early 33. And similarly across the world, it took a few years for everything to ramp up. Unlike that what we are seeing here, where everything has been hit so quickly. Of course, there are a lot more factors to consider between the two cases, but some have been speaking of this crisis as a repeat of the 30s, which in my opinion, it really isn't. You know, one way to prove this is the changes in unemployment. You know, it is really awful to see a dramatic rise in unemployment over the past year, which raised by about 2.7% throughout 2008 to about 7.6% of our population, or about 11.6 million people, which are unemployed. And while unemployment is still climbing, it is nowhere near what we saw in the Great Depression. You know, in contrast, during the Depression, peak of unemployment reached 25% in 1933, and the raise was a lot more steep over year on year on year as to what we're seeing today. And, you know, it skyrocketed way more dramatically than we're seeing today. And, you know, as troubling as the times are we're experiencing right now, I do believe that we will bounce back sooner rather than later.
That is absolutely terrible to hear. Truly have to feel for all these people that are affected. Anyway, on to the final question of the show, which positive things coming few and far between these days. What would you say is some of the positive things happening in your country's economies? Let's start with you, Max.
Well, for one, America is still the number one economy in the world, and although the unemployment rate is still much higher than we would have liked it to be, it has shown signs of slowing down. You know, signs are indicating that we are most likely entering the trough phase, which means we have hit the bottom and we can only go up from here. Another positive in the economy is the Recovery Act that has passed back in February. You know, the effects of the legislation are being seen now and will hopefully do what Franklin D. Roosevelt's New Deal did during the Great Depression. Although this stimulus package was quite expensive, the benefits of it have greatly outweighed the negatives in the short term so far. However, we do not know yet how they will affect our nation in the long term.
Yeah, in contrast from Max's point, a positive factor within the Cameroonian economy is that, especially after this great recession in America, we are blessed to be far from the epicenter of it. Even though this crash became a global economic crisis, us Cameroonians are still grateful to have had it quite easy on us in comparison to other countries which suffered far, far worse. We as a nation are working very hard to get back onto our feet and recover from this. And recently, international trade has been picking up a little better and our exports are back up and running. And we have high, high hopes for the future.
There does seem to be some promising things on the horizon, so that is something to look forward to. Thank you for the insight. That was very interesting. I'm sure everyone at home learned a lot, and myself included. Have a wonderful rest of the night, you two. All right, on to the final guest of this segment. We go to Mr. Edwards. Hello, Mr. Edwards. Before you joined, we just talked about economics. As a businessman who is not all biased, would you say that the current economic system we have in the States is good, or do you think there are flaws that we can improve upon in the future? First of all, hello there, Ethan. It is an honor to be on such a prestigious show as this one. Now on to your question. I think the economic system we have in America is the best in the world. It gives so many people from different backgrounds opportunities to succeed. You know, I find it sad that some people can't see what wonderful opportunities there are here. I see people rise all the time from poor families to rich. Here in the States, it doesn't matter what class you are born into. At the end of the day, everyone has the same chance to become successful, and I think that is truly beautiful about this great country we have here. Alright, thank you for your input, Mr. Edwards. That was very intriguing to get your thoughts on this topic. I hope you have a wonderful rest of the day. Well, folks, that is all. After the commercial break, we'll be back to talk about Obama during his first few months as president.